My name is Candace Steward, and I manage EastWest Recording Studios in Los Angeles. I believe I've been taking interns from CRAS for 15 years. Wow. Well, CRAS kind of does it for me, really. I mean, they screen them for me ahead of time somewhat. But what I look for in an intern is someone that is eager to learn, passionate about the craft of audio, and willing and knowing that they don't know everything yet. You know what I mean? That's a big thing for me. So that they're enthusiastic, but still realize that they have a lot to learn. And I look for someone that's really polite. Trustworthy is also something that comes into play. And I think someone that just understands and realizes that it's the beginning of the career. Well, from CRAS interns, what I've found as far as employable traits are that the background, that the curriculum of the school is gives them a very realistic view of what they're going to be getting into in the professional sector. I think that, you know, what they learn actually applies. You know, it's not like they go to a school and they end up working at McDonald's or something like that. It's like, this is an audio school. They're going to learn about audio from the best, and professionals in the industry have actually done these jobs. And they're employable because of the what they studied, really. Just the fact that they've chosen this school is a step ahead in the right direction. The curriculum at the school, it gives them two legs up big time going to CRAS because they're actually learning what they're going to need to know in the real world. You know, there's so many success stories with CRAS graduates coming through EastWest. I mean, Will Ansbach most recently was an intern at EastWest, then a runner, then an assistant. He went on to work for Alex DeKid. Andy's independent, already doing projects. Jeff Ellis is another one. Jeff was an intern, then a runner, then an assistant. Got on the Frank Ocean sessions for the first album and has now become Frank's engineer and working on the second record. Ben O'Neill, who was an intern, a runner, and an assistant in East West, now works with Mark Needham and is mixing records. Amazing stuff with Mark Needham. So yeah, a lot of success stories, and I'm sure if I'm not mentioning you and you are a success story that came out of CRAS and went to East West, send me an email. Well, first of all, when I first started, there were no schools. And then as the schools started to come along, I didn't have much luck with the schools, you know, until CRAS, frankly. I mean, some of the schools are still in business and I don't want to name names, but I've never really had any luck with anyone that was sent to me from another school except for CRAS. There are a couple other schools that are decent now that I'd entertain, you know, talking to people from. But realistically, I just think, again, I keep going back to the fact that the curriculum, I don't know if it reality-based is a proper description, but it pertains and is relevant to recording and to audio now. You know, both with the exposure to vintage gear as well as the fact that that at CRAS they look for new avenues and new areas where people can find, you know, gainful employment doing what they love. You know, I think the broadcast thing is just genius. I think the truck is genius. So I just think they're relevant and they stay relevant and they keep in touch with what's actually happening in the world of audio, music, post, gaming, broadcast. I mean, all of it, really.